guesstimate how much on a, from a normal year did you save percentage-wise on your corn and then also your soybeans by implementing biosugar grow? Just a rough guess.
So, that's kind of a tricky question based on how I had already took my cost of production that was this big, mm-hmm. and I went all in furrow with a planter and made it this big. And now I'm able to continue to trim it down with the BioSure Grow. So I can tell you for a fact that I saved $37 on my nitrogen program per acre with the BioSure Grow this year. Mm-hmm. That's fact just right off the top. And then you start factoring in chemical savings per acre.
Yeah.
You start factoring in, you know, your P and K savings per acre. Because the first thing that people started telling me when they learned that I was going in furrow with my P and K was, you can only do that for so long. Why? You know, they don't tell me, they don't have a reason, just that you can't, right? You're going to mine your soil, but the fact is that what I'm putting down is 100% readily available, and I've had the healthiest plants in the last 2 years running this liquid program, and then this year they were even healthier yet with the BioSure Grow. It's just an enhancer, right? And so my soil tests are telling me I'm not mining my soil, and I'm actually building my soil going in furrow with my liquid. So, like I said, I had already shrank my dollars per acre down a lot, but then this has helped before, and this has helped me go even further. So it's definitely saving me money across the whole broad spectrum of pretty much everything, from nitrogen to the P and K to chemicals. So.
Well, then let's talk a little bit about what you've seen on the chemicals and your first experience with that. You sent photos of the wheat burned down and stuff.
Yeah. So, with the chemical deal, it was a little scary as well. Because
what did we tell you to do?
You told me to, well, first you told me to do what I was comfortable with. You told me to whatever I felt like I needed to cut, pull that right back to go for it. You know, I could go clear down to like a third, I think, you know. And so I pulled it back and I just cut it back in half, used a pint of BioSure Grow, and I said, let's just see what happens. And, you know, it's a little slower kill, but it's a more effective kill than what I've seen. Because, and then we ended up running that across every acre with our burn down, and we used a 5-pound 2,4-D and a 4-pound glyphosate, which is usually we would use a 6-pound 2,4-D and a 5-pound glyphosate. So we used a weaker of the two,
version.
And still cut it in half of recommended rate. You know, we ran 16 ounces of glyphosate. We ran, I believe it was 6 ounces of the 2,4-D, which normally we would run 12. So, like I said, it was a little slower kill, but it was an effective kill, and it killed it from the bottom up.
Yeah.
So. I was very impressed.
Yeah, we've had some people inquire about it, and then they think, "Oh, you're just going to build resistance that way by cutting your rates back." But you're killing the weed completely, right?
Yeah, that's the thing. Like, in order to build resistance, you would have to hurt the plant and not kill it.
Yeah, it goes. Yeah.
So then it can come back with a vengeance. That's what we always say when we spray a plant and the spray doesn't work. The plant comes back. It's just indestructible. That's not what we're doing. We're actually killing it, killing the roots. When we came in with our high-speed disc this year, it was awesome because we just blew everything up. The roots turned loose of the dirt. It was just beautiful seedbed everywhere. Even when our sprayer, hung over a fescue waterway, it was killing mature fescue. Mature fescue is hard to kill. Anybody that's ever sprayed it knows you can't hardly kill mature. So, I think that's, to me, it is an issue, you know, it's something to worry about, but what I saw, no, we were not building resistance because Yeah, so, you know, previously in the years past, my dad had broke out some CRP that, you know, him and some other guys have told me, you know, takes 2 or 3 years for CRP ground to produce, to really wake it up. You know, it's the terminology everybody uses. You gotta wake that ground up. Well, I thought, what better way to wake it up than with some microbes, you know? So I kind of didn't really go into those fields really worried about what I was going to see, because I was pretty confident that the BioSure Grow would, you know, wake it up if that's what needed to happen. And sure enough, you know, first application got put on with the chemical, we burned it all down, and then came in and put it in furrow just like everything else. And I mean, those soybeans, especially the ones that didn't get drowned out, I mean, those things are gorgeous. You know, first year out of the gate, probably going to run, you know, 60, 65 bushel beans, maybe better in places. I mean, there's some places that look just as good as our irrigated ground. Some of these fields, like what we just went and looked at, what I would consider our worst bean field of the year, you know, those beans got hammered. They got the first planting, got drowned out. The BioSure Grow was with the first planting. I did not go back with it in for the second. Because I was not going to reapply my P and K. I didn't have orifices to go down and just put a gallon on again. So we went right back into the same furrow, planted right back in where we planted the first time. Honestly, been scared to even look at them all year because they got planted so late. CRP ground. It's just, it wasn't a good
situation.
A lot, yeah. And then it turned off hot and dry, and then I figured there wasn't anything out there. And so went back this past Sunday afternoon after church, and there, you know, there's 30, 35 pods per plant out there. And I'm tickled, honestly, because I didn't think I would have anything.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and my dad told me, you know, I wouldn't expect more than 20 to 30 bushel out of first year out of the gate with CRP beans. I just, almost unheard of, it seems like, with gas. But yeah, I think we're going to do all right for the first year out of the gate with those fields.
Yeah, you haven't cut them yet, but we'll find out soon enough.
So we'll find out.
Okay, so let's talk then. You've used the Plus B this year, first time.